José Toledo wasn't just considered a supervisor. He joined in making sure those Sliterbahn inner tubes were pumped up and that the world's best water park was ready for visitors.
He was there with them, and that's what his co-workers said. You know, José never made us do the work by ourselves. He was there with us.
Until one day 3 weeks ago, they say he complained he was feeling sick and was acting strangely.
He got a stick like a this used to paint.
The paint roller sticks.
And he was painting up in the sky.
But I don't understand why he wasn't driven to the hospital that is block away. Why was he driven to another property where he passed away?
Medical records provided by the family show he had no pulse. His body temperature hit 107 and only got down to 103, but it was too late. Toledo's family says they believe his death was kept low key because Sliterbahn was about to be sold. They also worry his death benefits could be in jeopardy because Toledo, a 22-year employee, was undocumented.
They appreciated his work for those two decades, so I don't understand.
The family tells me they've hired the same attorney who successfully sued Sliterbahn's owners after a little boy was decapitated at a Kansas City park. But for now, Toledo's daughter has this message for the company.
Your employees are important. They worked hard for y'all. Make sure they're okay.
In New Braunfels, Jesse Degollado, KSAT 12 News.
While the family of the employee has hired an attorney, the lawsuit has not actually been filed yet. Sliterbahn did provide a statement on that matter regarding José Toledo. It reads in part, "We were proud and blessed to count him as a member of the Sliterbahn family. We had been working directly with Mrs. Toledo and have no further information that we can share."